The second largest city in Romania by population, Cluj-Napoca is considered to be the heart of Transylvania, the central region of the country. The name, Cluj-Napoca, comes from the Latin word castrum clus, which means closed, and it refers to the hills that surround the city. The name in its current form was used for the first time in the 12th century to designate the fortress of the medieval town of this location, Napoca. Footprints of human existence on the territory of the current city exist since prehistory, the locality being mentioned for the first time by the Greek anthropological author Ptolemy as Napoca, the Dacian settlement. Following the Roman conquest from 105 to 106 CE, the ancient settlement disappeared and its place was taken by a locality built to rigorous Roman architectural standards. The former capital of Dacia Porolisensis, Cluj-Napoca is today the historic capital of Transylvania. Huge groups of Saxon colonists settled in the fortress of Cluj during the reign of Stefan IV of Hungary, after the decimation of the city's population during the attacks of the Tartars. By the end of the 15th century, the royal fortress, Castrum Cluj, achieved an urban organization system. Then, in 1405, the Roman-German Emperor, Sigismund of Luxembourg, who simultaneously became the King of Hungary, accorded Cluj the right of a free city. Gradually, Cluj became a center for production and trade. Approximately 5,000 people held occupations within the agricultural sector, in workshops, and also in entertainment specific to the town. Back then, the city's population comprised of Saxons, Hungarians, and Romanians. The Bathory dynasty also contributed to the economic and demographic growth, bringing the fortress to a rank that could be compared only to Brasov. Gabriel Bethlen, the Prince of Transylvania, became protector of the city and helped with the development and perfection of Cluj as an important stronghold. Cluj became a city again, after which, for a duration of over 6 years, the people of Cluj lived through humiliation and injustice until Iancu de Hunedoara restored their old freedoms. Perhaps the prince was appeased by the fact that a year and a half earlier, his son, Matias, was born in Cluj, and residents were welcoming to the child and his mother. On hearing the news that their city was restored its rights, the people of Cluj were so happy that to honor the event and always remember he who had restored their freedoms, they changed the entrance to the great church, which had already been built and was almost finished. A statue of the Archangel Michael, celebrated in the Catholic world precisely on September 29th, was carved above the entrance of the west, which is the entrance presently used. Banfi Palace, the Museum of Art, was built on the demand of Count Gheorghe Banfi, who soon after became the governor of Transylvania. It was built between 1774 and 1785 by the German architect Johann Eberhard Blaumann, and it is the most representative edifice from Transylvania built in the Baroque style. The Museum of Art was founded in 1951, and 5 years later, it started functioning in the Banfi Palace. It was the second museum in the country representing the dowry of Romanian art. The museum owns plastic and decorative works of art, medieval collections, modern and contemporary works, religious Transylvanian portraits, and old religious relics. The row of mythological statues on the frontispiece, between which, centrally located, is the Banfi family crest, gives a unique visual effect and scene. The palace itself saw many important guests, from Emperor Francis I and Empress Carolina, until the penultimate emperor of the Austro-Hungarian Empire, Franz Joseph, and Empress Sisi. Even the composer Franz Liszt, who had a series of concerts in the palace's halls, paid a visit. Since 1951, the palace hosts Cluj's Museum of Art, with a valuable patrimony of paintings, graphics, and decorative arts. The core of this patrimony is the Virgil Cioflec collection, that brings together works of artists including Nicolae Grigorescu, Ștefan Lucian, Dimitrie Păciura, Teodor Paladi, Camil Resu, and Vasile Popescu. The core exhibition also presents the works of some lesser-known Transylvanian artists from the 18th and 19th centuries, and an important collection of highly valuable works belonging to the painting school of Baia Mare. The Tailor's Tower was built during the 15th century. It was a privilege accorded to the people of Cluj in 1405 by the King of Hungary because Sigismund of Luxembourg was supported by the Tailor's Guild. Initially, the role of the Tailor's Tower was to defend the southeast corner of the extended fortified enclosure of the medieval city. Therefore, over time, the tower had a defensive role. This proved highly important in armed confrontations, as the tower was attacked many times by the troops who disputed their ownership of Transylvania. As a matter of fact, the Tailor's Tower was actually blown up so as not to fall into the hands of the Imperials. After several destructions, the tower and its parts were restored, once even on the expense of the citizens. This happened in 1718, when the citizens ensured the purchase and transportation of 150 stone carts, materials for the interior woodwork, and 40,000 pieces of shingle for the roof. To the right of the bastion is Baba Novak's statue, a Serbian mercenary and outlaw who consequently fought against the Ottoman Empire and was the captain of Mihai Viteazu's army of outlaws. He is Serbia's national hero and is highly respected as a military personality in Romania. In 1601, while he was on a mission, Baba Novak was arrested by the Hungarian authorities in Cluj on charges of theft, and he was condemned to death and eventually burned at the stake in Cluj's fortress. The Cavalry Church of Manastur, dedicated to Saint Mary, is the oldest historic and architectural monument kept in the former village of Cluj-Manastur. Beginning in the second half of the 11th century, the Benedictine Abbey, Monasterium Betae Mariae de Cluj, functioned within the country's royal fortress and was surrounded by a defensive wall. What remains of the old building is only the church's choir, which has a simple ship, constructed in the 19th century on the old foundations. The church is surrounded by a tall wave of land, resulting from the fortifications carried out during the Middle Ages, when the entire area had defense grooves to the south, east, and west, and towards the north there was a natural steep slope. The Greek Catholic Church was built in the Baroque architectural style between 1775 and 1779 by the Roman Catholic Order of the Brothers of the Conventual Minors, popularly referred to as the Minorites, the oldest branch of the Franciscans. The church was built on the site of the former Henter House and other neighboring lands obtained by exchange, of which Francisc Kirtner was both the architect and designer. The funds necessary for the build came from a donation made by Empress Maria Theresia, who was at that time the Great Princess of Transylvania. Due to some construction errors, however, the church's tower came tumbling down, taking a victim with it. 3 years later, the tower and facade were rebuilt under the direction of architect Johann Eberhard Blaumann. In 1924, Pope Pius IX decided to name the church as the property of the Romanian Church United with Rome, or the Greek Catholic Church. This decision led the Franciscan monks to barricade themselves inside the building. Security forces were required to intervene in order to evacuate the monks. The facade of the building was carried out according to a coherent artistic design in the Baroque style. Architect Blaumann created the entrance very powerfully, with a jetty arched towards the exterior and bound over the corners of the facade, towards which there existed a distance of 3.60 meters. This solution generated a striking and dynamic element in accordance to Baroque demands. Pillars located along the facade, as well as on the tower flanks, have simple Dorian caps, above which runs an entablement with a doubled architrave. The prominent cornice, or ledge, is located at a height of 10.10 meters from the base. The Lucian Blaga Central University Library of Cluj is one of the oldest and most important university libraries in Romania, with valuable collections including medieval incunabula and many rare bibliophilic publications. The library features 55 reading halls and a capacity of 2,100 seats for readers. It was founded in 1872, together with the Francis Joseph University in Cluj, by merging with the Library of the Transylvanian Museum, established in 1859. Initially, it functioned in the main building of Cluj's university, and in 1906, the construction of the current mansion of the library began, according to the blueprints of architects Calman Gergo and Flores Corb. The building was finished in 1908, and the library collections were moved to their new location between 1908 and 1909, while the expansion of the new premises continued until 1934. Papyrus Church, formerly known as the Jesuits Church of Cluj, or the University Church, given its location on University Street, is dedicated to the Holy Trinity. It was the first Catholic church built in Transylvania after the Protestant Reformation, and also the first clerical edifice built in the Baroque style within the province. The church constituted an architectonic ensemble, together with the academic Jesuit college, where today lies the main building of the Babish Bolya University. This place of worship showcases a sharp contrast between the austere and monumental exterior as compared to an ornate, almost exuberant interior, a jewel in the Baroque style. Until 1959, at the front of the church was a statue of the Virgin Mary, a monument that was later moved by the communist authorities to a location behind St. Peter's Church in Cluj. The church is laterally surrounded by two massive clock towers, each with a height of 45 meters, raised vertically with two pairs of gradual monumental pillars, between which lies the central section, the most important in terms of composition and layout, bounded by a strong ledge. The pillars have iconic column heads designed in the specific Baroque style. Beneath the central window, a small balcony with banisters arches gracefully outwards. Beneath this balcony is the pediment, split above the main entrance. The cleft of the pediment is broad to make room for the two angles that support a bas relief representing the Holy Trinity, with the inscription "Honori Sanctissime Trinitatis" in Latin, meaning "In honor of the Holy Trinity." In the altar lies a religious iconography of the Virgin Mary, painted on wood and wrapped in metal, who, it is told, in 1699 cried for 2 weeks, a fact confirmed by the testimonies of several people. It is assumed that this religious iconography is the original one from the Nicula Monastery. Beneath the Virgin Mary are the statues of two saints of the Jesuits' order, St. Francis and St. Ignatius, which were brought to the Papyrus Church in 1726 from Vienna. The pulpit, a masterpiece of Anton Schubauer's, is decorated on the outside with relief carvings of the four evangelists, and in the space between the pulpit and its crown is a bas relief with the most important saints of the Jesuits. On the pulpit crown is an image of St. Michael. Beneath the church building is a crypt with 140 funeral places. The Papyrus High School, currently known as the Bathory Istvan Theoretical High School, is considered to be the spiritual heir of the Jesuit school founded in 1579 by Stephen Bathory, the prince. He entrusted the order to build the school even since the foundation of the teaching tasks, and with their help, in addition to the schools of an inferior rank, he laid the foundation for a superior school in 1581. Jesuit monks were banished from the city in 1603, but beginning in 1615, they returned to Cluj Monastir. Their importance in the religious and cultural life of Transylvania grew since the late 17th century, concurrently with the integration of the Transylvanian Principality into the provincial system of the Habsburg Empire. In place of that present school was built a one-story school in 1727, following the completion of the church and the Jesuit monastery. The current building of the school, as it can be seen today, was built between 1817 and 1821, using the blueprints of engineer Friedrich Thallinger. The most important section of this monument is a colossal neoclassical facade, on which the vertical joins through gigantic pillars of the top two stories rest on the rhythmic arches of the ground floor. The Gheorghe Dima Academy of Music was founded in 1919 as a state institution. The establishment of the Conservatory of Music and Dramatic Art inaugurated the modern stage of higher education for musical studies in Transylvania. The first chancellor, composer Gheorghe Dima, instated the ideal of high-quality standards to the new institute, which he thoroughly acquired during his university studies in Germany. The European vocation and worship to quality constituted then, and continues to constitute, an important constant value throughout the entire history of the institution. The church was built between the end of the 15th century and the beginning of the 16th century with the support of King Mattia Corvin. Renowned for its acoustics, the Reformed Church is one of the largest Gothic constructions in Transylvania. In front of the church is a statue of Saint George slaying the dragon, a copy of one of the first and most famous bronze equestrian statues of the 14th century. Created in 1373 by Cluj sculptors Martin and George, the demand of Emperor Karol IV, the statue now forms part of the collection of the National Gallery of the Royal Palace in Prague. The former Jesuit monastery is on Manastur Road, and it functioned for a long time as the monastery as well as a college, the one which Babish Bolyai stems from. Hundreds of years ago, this building was considered to be one of the landmarks of Cluj, even if it was located outside the medieval walls of the city. The history of the building begins with a medieval house that a certain Barbara Zentpali purchased in 1605 and later gifted to the Jesuits in 1626. Banished from the city in 1603, the Jesuit order returned to the Cluj area in 1615 when they received the possession of the current Cavalry Church, unfortunately in ruins. Because they did not have a better building close at hand, the monastery and the Jesuit college operated in that building donated by Barbara Zentpali until 1670. The Unitarian Church was built between 1792 and 1796, and it is presently classified as an historic monument. Constructed in the Baroque style, with Rococo, or late Baroque, and neoclassical elements, the shrine was designed by Viennese architect Anton Turk. Above the entrance gateway is a Latin inscription that reads, "In honor of the one God, 1796. Inside the church is a round stone. Legend shares that in 1568, Francis David held a sermon here, after which the citizens of Cluj moved to a Unitarian regime. The church underwent a series of repairs and restorations between 1805 and 1806, coordinated by architect Joseph Leder. In 1831, the church was reinforced laterally, since it appeared that the oversized arch could collapse. In 1908, architect Leos Peikki completed the tower. The church currently fulfills the function of the cathedral for the whole Unitarian Church of Romania. This school is the successor to an academic institution founded in 1557 by the Unitarian Bishop. The high school functioned in several buildings, within the building of the School of Music, and in the 19th century within the building where the Victor Babish School existed. From 1901, the high school is based in the building designed by Leos Peikki on the boulevard named 21st December 1989, near the Unitarian Church. Between 1948 and 1993, the Janos Sigismund High School closed, and in its building worked only the students of the Brasai Samuel High School. In 1993, it was reopened, and in 2003, renamed after John Sigismund Zaploia, the first prince of the Principality of Transylvania. The Roman Catholic Church of St. Michael is an historic and religious architectural monument built between 1350 and 1487 as one of the most imposing Gothic buildings in Romania, with the highest tower in Transylvania. The vestry gateway was built in 1528 and contains motifs specific to the Renaissance era and a strong South German influence. The Mattia Corvin sculpted ensemble is located near the church, and it is the work of sculptor Janos Fadrus, the grand prize winner of the World Exhibition in Paris in 1900. The ensemble depicts the royal Mattia Corvin in majestic equestrian attire, surrounded as per tradition by four of his governors. The church was built on a land that had served as a cemetery where a chapel dedicated to Saint James had existed. The primary document kept was one that was issued by the papal court of Avignon in January 1349, through which the sins of those who financially supported the construction of the church were forgiven. In 1697, the tower was destroyed by a fire and rebuilt in the Baroque style in 1744. However, it had to be demolished in 1763, after an earthquake greatly damaged it and it risked collapsing. The building of the current clock tower in a Gothic style began in 1837. It was built on the northern facade and finished in 1860. To this day, the tower holds its place as the tallest church tower in Romania. During the Protestant Reformation, the edifice served diverse religious communities. Thus, in the period between 1545 and 1558, it was a Lutheran church. Between 1558 and 1566, it became Calvinist, and in 1566, it became a Unitarian church. It remained so for a period of 150 years, until it was forcefully attributed to the Roman Catholic community as a result of the Counter-Reform. After returning to the Catholics, the church was restored with an influence of the Baroque style by artists Johannes Nachtigal and Anton Schubauer, under the guidance of Pastor Jano Spiro. The artists also brought the pulpit to life at the same time. Over time, the building was witness to various milestones, among which the christening of Mattia Corvin and the teachings of Queen Isabella, who taught the royal insignia messengers of Emperor Ferdinand I within the chamber. Additionally, it was here that the Transylvanian princes Gabriel Bethlen, Sigismund Rákóczi, Sigismund Báthory, and Gabriel Báthory were invested. The church is a Gothic building with a domed choir, of which the pointed arches are adorned in crosses and guarded by the lateral altars. The dome, stained glass, and sculptures are characterized by greatness specific to Gothic cathedrals. Above the entrance gate is an emblem representing Saint Michael, beneath which lie the coats of arms of the Holy Roman Empire, the Hungarian Kingdom, and the Kingdom of Bohemia. The existence of these coats of arms is explained by the fact that Emperor Sigismund of Luxembourg, who lived between 1387 and 1437, under whose reign it appears the building was finished, was a Roman emperor, and at the same time, the King of Hungary and of Bohemia. Of special artistic importance is the Schlönig Chapel, located in the southwest corner of the building to the right of the main entrance, and dedicated to the Archangel Michael. The ceiling on the pointed arches of the chapel was completed around 1481. The most important frescoes of the church are kept inside the chapel. The door frame to the vestry is a Renaissance sculpture in stone dating from 1528. At that time, it was commissioned by the parish priest Johannes Klein and built by a German master builder. The Gothic altar, work of master carpenter Leos Bach, was honored at the World Exhibition in 1873, which took place in Vienna. The Virgin Mary, together with Saint Stephen and Saint Ladislas, are carved in the center of the altar. Unfortunately, most of the frescoes from the 14th and 15th centuries have not stood the test of time. Romanian Orthodox Metropolis of Cluj, Alba, Crișana, and Maramureș, Archbishop of Vad, Felac, and Cluj, is located on number 18 Avram Iancu Square. The metropolis was built between 1923 and 1933 using the blueprints of architects Constantin Pomponiu and George Cristinel, and following the Romanian style at the time. It is one of the key religious buildings in the municipality of Cluj-Napoca. It is dedicated to the Assumption of the Virgin Mary on August 15, 1916, the date when the Romanian army entered Transylvania. In 1973, at the same time as the rise of Cluj's eparchial seat to the ranks of archbishop, the place of worship became the Archiepiscopal Cathedral. In 1996, the cathedral entered a long process to restore the exterior. The restoration eventually finished in 1999, and the interior was also painted in the Byzantine style, carried out in the famous Murano mosaic. The Orthodox Archbishopric of Cluj, inaugurated in 1938 and reorganized in 1975, has a valuable collection of religious and documentary art. The backdrop consists of liturgical objects and painted religious iconography from the 17th to the 19th centuries. The museum collection includes documents concerning the 16th century history of the eparchy, religious objects, religious iconography on wood and glass from the 17th century, manuscripts, garments, crosses, chalices, prints of ethnographic nature, and testimonials about the past of the Romanian nation. The Roman Catholic Franciscan Church and Monastery is one of the oldest and most significant buildings in the city. Originally, an older Romanian Catholic church existed in this location. It was the first of its kind in Cluj, built in the 11th and 12th centuries, but destroyed during the first invasion of the Tartars in 1241. After its destruction, a late Romanesque-style church was built in its place between 1260 and 1290, and then rebuilt in a Gothic style during the 15th century. The church was enlarged, adhering to the Gothic style, and a monastery was built beside it, with the support of the ruler Juan of Hunedoara, with a complex returning to the Dominican order. Following the banishment of the Catholic religious orders by the Protestants in March 1556, the monastery building was no longer used for religious purposes. Isabella, the Queen of Hungary, lived in the building until 1557, after which the abode was transformed into the Unitarian school in 1558. In 1609, at the desire of Prince Gabriel Báthory, the building was donated to the Reformed Calvin worshippers. In the year 1728, the Franciscans, who had returned to the city, initiated a campaign to restore the church and built the church tower in a Baroque style. The whole monastery church is arranged on three sides around an interior courtyard towards which the broken arches of the turrets opened. The monastic rooms housed cellars, library rooms, common dormitories, and administrative spaces, among others. Inside the monastery is a famous library of the Franciscans, a collection that surpasses 1,000 volumes. In the period between 1906 and 1948, the monastery of St. Bonaventura opened as a printing house, printing various religious magazines. From the year 1898, Carolina Obelisk found a new home in front of the church, following its move from Union Square. In 1949, the dwelling of the Franciscans was confiscated by the communist authorities, who decided to dissolve the Franciscan order in Romania, and so the monastery building housed the School of Music, later known as the Sigismund Toduca High School of Music, that still exists today. Since 1990, the church has returned to the property of the Romanian Catholic Franciscan Order, along with some of the old monastery. Above the entrance of the church is the statue of the Virgin Mary, protector of the church. On the frontispiece, two works of the sculptor Johannes Nachtigall are placed, namely, a statue of St. Francis and one of St. Anthony. Inside, you can admire the pulpit, another work of Johannes Nachtigall's. The pulpit was decorated with a representation of Jesus surrounded by the four evangelists. On the pulpit crown, Jesus' ascension into heaven is depicted, and on the main altar is a reproduction of a painting from the Santa Maria Maggiore Church in Rome, made in 1730 and depicting Saint Mary. The Neolog Synagogue on Horea Street is one of the symbolic buildings of Cluj-Napoca and the only operational synagogue in the city. The building, of Moorish style, is also known as the Memorial Temple to the Deported. The synagogue was built by the company of brothers Horvath and Karoli Remeniuk, according to the blueprint of railway engineer Hegner Isidor from Cluj, and opened in the late 19th century. In 1904, the synagogue was expanded with a group of buildings that housed the rabbinate, the community offices, a kindergarten, and an elementary school. In 1927, like other synagogues, it was robbed and vandalized by students of the Iron Guard who were passing through Cluj. In 1944, it was blown up by retreating German and Hungarian troops, and according to other sources, the synagogue was also the victim of bombings that occurred in June earlier that year. In 1947, it was rebuilt and named the Memorial Temple to the Deported. The Museum Square is the oldest square in the city, and it is open only for pedestrian traffic. It is richly adorned with Gothic and Baroque architectural and religious ensembles, and with Roman archaeological sites. The Franciscan Church and Monastery, the home of Mattia Corvin, the Boczai House, the Carolina Obelisk, and the National Museum of Transylvanian History are all located here. Mattia Corvin's house is the house in which Mattia Corvin, one of the most powerful and scholarly kings of Hungary, the son of Romanian Prince Iancu de Hunedoara, was born in 1443. The house is an historic and secular monument built in the 15th century, whose interior contains a series of late Gothic architectural elements. Today, the University of Arts and Design functions within Mattia Corvin's house. The Carolina Column is Cluj's first secular monument. with all other monuments that had been built until then having religious significance. It was built in honor of Austrian Empress Carolina Augusta, who in 1817, together with her husband, Emperor Francis I, visited Cluj with the aim to strengthen the loyalty of the subjects in this part of the empire. As a result, the people of Cluj began a construction project dedicated to the visit. The project was paused due to a lack of funds and was later completed following a donation of 16,000 Hungarian forints from Cluj's prosecutor, Imre Topler, who hoped to be granted the degree of nobility which he had requested after completing the obelisk. The obelisk has a height of 10 meters, and on three of its sides, the imperial visit is depicted on the bas reliefs. The bas reliefs depict the coat of arms of Cluj, a Latin inscription that recalls the visit of Empress Carolina, the entry of the imperial procession into Cluj through the middle gate of the city, and a visit to the city hospital. On the obelisk itself are an angel bearing effigies in a laurel wreath, and the four stone vultures who hold the laurels in their beaks. These are the works of two people from Cluj, sculptor Anton Soros and art teacher Samuel Nagy, and the reliefs depicting moments of the king's visit were made by the Viennese sculptor Josef Kleber. The city walls of Cluj can still be seen today, given that after 1241, after the invasion of the Tartars, the city's fortress was fortified, much like had been done in other medieval cities, with an imposing stone wall with towers at the entrance gates of each corner into the city. The Alexandru Borza Botanical Garden is one of the most beautiful and most complex botanical gardens in Europe, founded in 1872 and reorganized in 1920 by Professor Alexandru Borza. With an area of 14 hectares, this national museum contains a number of main attractions, namely the Romanian and Japanese gardens, a greenhouse complex with equatorial and tropical plants, a botanical museum, and the herbarium of the university. Over 120 taxa of tulips, hyacinths, crocuses, and daffodils grow here every spring. In the summer months, about 350 varieties of rose populate this area. Traditional healing plants used by the people of Romania and the Romanian pharmaceutical makers are also cultivated here. In the garden, there are two other main areas of interest, the Botanical Museum and the Herbarium, which contains 655,000 sheets from all over the world of significant scientific value that are always available to students and researchers, both from Romania and from abroad. The Amazon water lily, or Victoria cruziana, its taxonomic name, is one of the celebrities of the botanical garden in Cluj-Napoca, and by the end of August reaches its maximum size, both the flowers and the leaves. By this time, the leaves of this lily can sustain a weight of up to 20 kilograms. The Amazon water lily is planted each year at the end of January by the employees of the botanical garden. The plant sprouts in April and dies in late November. The water in which it grows is kept at an even temperature of between 28 and 30 degrees Celsius. The flowering cycle is short. The bud opens in the evening and closes overnight. After reopening in the morning, it begins to change color. The immaculate white gradually becomes pink, all the while gradually closing. Although the fleeting lily flower only lives for about 24 hours, visitors have nothing to worry about because during the summer, a lily flower is born every 2 to 3 days. The Pharmacy Museum is located in the building of the oldest pharmacy as certified in writing in 1573 and owned throughout by the families of pharmacists Swartz, Mauch, and Hintz. The collection of the pharmacy's history was started by a brilliant historian of medical sciences, Julius Orient, and is the most significant in Romania. In 1766, a general renovation occurs. It is then that the officina, painted murals, are realized, as well as the fillings in the walls, and the main facade is also remodeled. A photograph from 1868 depicts the house as having decorative grooves on the ground floor, while the first floor was decorated with pillars and windows with decorative frames and semicircular panels with embossed decorations. A new image from 1904 shows further changes. The panels above the openings were rebuilt with new plaster borders, closed in a circular segment, and decorated with distinct brackets in the shape of a spiral. In 1950, a room was snatched from the body of the house to become a pedestrian passage that still exists today. Thus was created the alleyway known to the people of Cluj today, and there were also other changes, as the building received a simple facade without elements of decoration. The Babeș Bolyai University is the largest university in the country, with over 45,500 students in 167 specializations, of which 98 are taught in Romanian, 52 in Hungarian, 13 in German, and 4 in English. The institution name comes from two prominent personalities of Transylvania, the Romanian researcher, Victor Babeș, and the Hungarian mathematician, János Bolyai. The university is the most prestigious educational establishment in Transylvania, thus establishing the city of Cluj-Napoca as the principal university center of this region, ranking second of the most important ones in the country. The current building was constructed between 1893 and 1903 by the architect Carol Meissner, containing 21 faculties at present. Between March and July 1959, the process of unifying the Romanian university from Cluj with the Hungarian university took place, and the new institution was named the Babeș Bolyai University, which had, at the beginning, 6 faculties. The Museum of the Babeș Bolyai University was established at the initiative of the rector of the Babeș Bolyai University in April 2001 in order to highlight the particularly rich history of the university education in Cluj over the centuries. This included the work of teachers and students who attended the various faculties, and especially the particularly remarkable contributions of Transylvanian intellectuals in the fields of cultural heritage and world sciences. The collections of the museum currently include over 750 original and facsimile pieces. Using these documents, the history and activity of all the colleges, faculties, and universities that successively existed in Cluj-Napoca have been restored, beginning with the 16th century until today. The first hall of the museum houses a mini technical collection of old appliances from the faculties of physics, chemistry, and biology, used over time in applied research. A special section of the University Museum is dedicated exclusively to the great personalities of the Cluj universities, who over time have made outstanding contributions to both the development of this institution and the advancement of science and world culture, including Emil Dracovița, Constantin Diacoviciu, Hermann Oberth, Lucian Blaga, Petre Sergescu, Augustin Maior, and Eugen Speranția, among others. Among the exhibits with great historical and scientific value, a collection of vintage photos specifically stands out, with a total of around 500 negatives that eloquently present important milestones of university life, particularly from the interwar period. Other particularly impressive pieces include copies of bachelor's degrees, doctoral degrees, and student cards dating from the 19th century to present day. Hermann Oberth is rightfully considered to be the father of astronautics and the inventor of rocket science worldwide. He was born into a family of Transylvanian Saxons in Sibiu on June 25, 1894, and in 1917, at the mere age of 23, had already devised the model of a rocket powered by ethanol and oxygen. Between 1941 and 1943, Oberth worked on a German Army missile testing station at Peenemünde, where the V-2 rocket was developed, although he wasn't directly involved in this rocket's design. The missile technology from both the Soviet Union and the United States are based on research conducted by Hermann Oberth long before the practical implementation of these techniques. The National Museum of Transylvanian History is built in a neoclassical style and is based in an architectural monument building of the 19th century, the Petrichevi Horvath Daniel House, a patron of the arts and literature. The museum has been open to the public since 1937 and features one of the largest and most well-organized departments of ancient history in the country, a valuable picture gallery, a collection of medieval and modern ceramics, a medieval lapidary, and an ethnographic collection. It is here that lays an image painted by Hungarian painter Gyula Meres Müller from Cluj, who lived at the end of the 19th and early 20th centuries, that depicts the coat of arms of the Corvins. Hungarian folk legend refers to the ring of King Sigismund of Hungary that had been stolen by a raven. According to the legend told by Heltai, King Sigismund, who was passing through the Hunedoara County, made a stop and stayed in the house of a local nobleman, proceeding to fall in love with the nobleman's daughter. From their relationship was later born the future governor of Hungary, Iancu de Hunedoara. In parting, King Sigismund had given the young girl a ring, advising her, if she deemed it necessary, to come to the royal court and seek his help, with a ring meant to facilitate the girl's access into the courtyard. After the birth of Janku, the young girl made her way towards Buda's courtyard to seek Sigismund's help in raising the child, taking with her the ring that the king had given her. On the way, however, the ring was snatched from the hands of the child by a raven, but the moment's desperation of the young mother's was cut short, as her brother, who managed to shoot down the raven with his arrow, was able to recover the ring. Thus, the way to Buda was continued, and all ended well. Sigismund recognized the young mother and took the child into his care, raising him at the Royal Hungarian Court. Celebrating 200 years after the famous Battle of Waterloo on June 18, 1815, that concluded with a devastating defeat of the French army and Napoleon's second abdication, the museum organized an exhibition presenting the collection of Napoleonic medals kept in the numismatic cabinet of the museum. These medals make reference to numerous military, political, cultural, and social events, and overall, they represent a captivating insight into a tumultuous period in the history of France and Europe, marked decisively by Napoleon. For Napoleon, the medals were an excellent means of propaganda, and this is why the emperor consistently supported the founding of institutions responsible for issuing them, as well as awarding the French engravers who produced true masterpieces of artistic craftsmanship. The Ethnographic Museum is the first of its kind in Romania, founded in 1922 by Professor Romulus Vuia. It comprises two sections, the Pavilion section and the Romulus Vuia Ethnographic Park. Since 1957, it is housed in Reduța Palace, an historical monument that hosted the historic Diet of Transylvania between 1848 and 1868, and from wherein the memorandum trial began in 1894. The museum holds a collection of over 92,000 items of folk culture, including occupations and traditional customs, ceramics, textiles, costumes, sport items, housing, and food. And since 2009, the museum houses a permanent tactile exhibition dedicated to people with visual impairment. The building in which the administrative headquarters of the Ethnographic Museum is located was named after the main hall of the building called Reduța. In the Middle Ages, there were three buildings on this site, of which a Renaissance frame from the beginning of the 17th century remained from one of the buildings. In the 18th century, the most important of Cluj's inns operated here, bearing the name White Horse. Emperor Joseph II, who lived here between 1780 and 1790, changed the purpose of the building, turning it into a school for officers. The city reclaimed the building in 1794, and in the next decades carried out extensive renovation works completed after 1830. These works were carried out according to the blueprints of the most important architects of the era, Joseph Leder, Mihaly Kind, Georg Winkler, and Anton Kagerbauer. In the 19th century, the Reduța Hall hosted countless important events in the political and cultural history of Transylvania. Several sessions with Transylvania's leaders took place here, during which extremely important decisions were adopted in the history of the great Principality of Transylvania. Some of the greatest musicians in the world also performed in this hall, including Franz Liszt, Johannes Brahms, Béla Bartók, and George Ionescu. In 1894, the famous political process known as the Memorandists' Trial was held in this room, brought by the Hungarian authorities of the Romanian National Movement Leaders Era. During this trial, the leader of the Romanian National Party, Dr. Ioan Rațiu, uttered the historic words, "The existence of a nation is not discussed, it is stated." In 1897, the first cinematic projection in the city's history took place in the Reduța Hall. The building also hosted conferences and meetings of the political parties and cultural associations, fencing tournaments, and masquerades. The Romulus Vuia National Ethnographic Park in Cluj-Napoca, the first open-air museum in Romania, was founded on June 1, 1929 as a branch of the Ethnographic Museum of Transylvania by the decree of the Ministry of Culture and Art. The founder of the park, ethnographer Romulus Vuia, adopted for a form of organization in which some original rural households were to be inhabited by peasants involved in traditional economic activities. The initial area of the park was of 75 hectares. During the Second World War, most of the buildings in the ethnographic park were destroyed. The beginnings of the Cluj Metropolitan Museum date back to 1924, during the time of Bishop Nicholas Ivan. However, it isn't until 1938 that the Diocesan Museum opens to the public in a few rooms on the second floor of the bishop's residence. The collections included objects of worship, religious iconography, prints and manuscripts, and documents concerning the history of the church. The museum was reorganized by modern criteria in 1975 and reopened to the public in the same location. The patrimony of the museum was enriched with numerous religious iconography, old prints, documents, and objects of worship, and it is currently considered to be one of the most important collections of ancient Romanian art in the country. The great theologian and scholar, Metropolitan Bartolomeo Anania, launched the planning of the space in the basement of the cathedral, within which the permanent exhibition of the Metropolitan Museum was organized. The museum was reorganized in 2011 following a scientific and modern design, a cultural artistic heritage comprising old religious iconography painted on wood and glass, objects of worship, manuscripts and rare books, and objects and documents on the history of the Diocese of Cluj. Dominated by the statue of Stephen the Great, founder and protector of the Orthodox hierarchs from Vad and Felak, the first hall of the museum is dedicated to the great hierarchs of the Romanian Orthodox Diocese of Cluj. Bishop Nicolae Ivan, founder and builder of the cathedral, who led between 1921 and 1936, Bishop Nicolae Colan, a defender and true shepherd of his flock, who became a Metropolitan of Transylvania and led between 1936 and 1957, the good Archbishop Teofil Herinanu, a man who rose above his time through his many great spiritual qualities and led between 1957 and 1992, and finally, Archbishop and Metropolitan Bartolomeu, the great hierarch, interpreter of the Bible, founder of the Metropolitan of Cluj, scholar and writer, playwright and poet, who led between 1993 and 2001. Besides the first museum hall is the Hierarch's Necropolis, a space arranged beneath the apse of the cathedral's altar, like a chapel, with the tombs of Bishop Nicolae Ivan, Archbishop Teofil Herinanu, and Metropolitan Bartolomeu. A part of the rich collection of the religious silk or linen cloths kept in the assets of the museum are symbolically exhibited, most dating from the 18th century. These are not only important liturgical objects, but at the same time, they represent graphic artworks of documentary significance for the history of the Romanian Church in Transylvania. In the place of honor is the religious iconography of the Virgin Mary with Child from the Ilișua Village Church, painted in 1673 by Luca Avi Claude, author of the famous miraculous iconography from the Nicula Monastery. In the space beneath the narthex of the cathedral, many iconographies from the 18th century are exhibited. Two halls are devoted to iconography on glass, illustrating the different phases of the oldest Transylvanian glass painting center that existed at the Nicula Monastery and in the nearby village. Of particular value are the iconographies dating from the 18th century painted at Nicula, with the museum having one of the richest collections in Romania. The Mineralogical Museum that works as part of the Department of Mineralogy at the Babeș Bojea University Faculty of Biology and Geology was originally designed as a place of study and to deepen knowledge for student geologists and specialists in the field. In 2002, the educational collection of minerals and rocks was opened to the public. Currently, the museum contains over 16,500 exhibits, of which around 12,500 minerals, over 3,700 machined gemstones, and more than 200 meteorites, clustered in several thematic collections based on systematic and geographic criteria. The systematic mineral collection illustrates more than 700 different mineral species from around the world. It is the richest scientific systematic collection in Romania. It includes an important collection of 450 samples of native gold, mostly from the area of Roșia Montană. The collection of Romanian gemstones is the only systematic presentation of this type in the country that highlights the local natural potential of fine stone, especially represented by varieties of quartz and ornamental rocks. The collection of precious and fine gemstones brings together 250 pieces of machined minerals, including diamond, emerald, aquamarine, ruby, and more, in a vintage cabinet from the 19th century. The meteorite collection is the only one of its kind in Romania. It brings together over 200 exhibits from all around the world. The core of the collection of meteorites is a set of fragments from the Mox meteorite that fell in 1882 in the Mociu commune in Cluj. The largest of these fragments weighs 35.7 kilograms. The Paleontology Stratigraphy Museum belongs to the Faculty of Biology and Geology of the Babeș Bojea University and has a long history and rich scientific tradition. The core of the museum comprises old collections belonging to the Transylvanian Museum, which was founded in 1859. In 1872, when the University of Cluj was founded, within the Faculty of Science there were two relevant departments, the Department of Mineralogy and the Department of Geology. Renowned geologist A. Koch, appointed as head of the geology and paleontology department of the time, was the one who laid the foundations for the Museum of Paleontology. Today, the museum holds more than 50,000 specimens, of which about 30,000 are on permanent display. The Zoological Museum is part of the Babish Bolya University patrimony and consists of several scientific collections of animals, now totaling over 300,000 pieces. Exhibits are presented in several forms of conservation: stuffed, dried, preserved in conserving liquid, and skeletons. The exhibits are arranged both in phylogenetic order, reflecting the evolution of the animal kingdom from simple to complex, as well as through dioramas, showing the interrelationships of the species that form the animal world. Themed insectariums are also exhibited, showing variations in the size of butterflies during the rainy season as compared to during the drought, aspects of copied and mimicked adaptation in butterflies and larvae, and also drafting stages of the silk fibers from the silk butterfly, or Bombyx diae, its binomial name. The aspects of reed birds' lives are illustrated with the types of nests that they build, and also within the wildlife diorama of the Barragan Plain. The cabinet with hummingbirds draws attention through the variety of changing colors that are obtained based on the light that falls on the birds' bodies. And, in the microdiorama in which the orioles are displayed, you can observe the phenomenon of sexual dichroism in the place where the nest is built. The Vivarium Museum was built between 1998 and 2000 and includes about 57 species of animals. When it opened in 2001, it housed only a collection of reptiles and amphibians. Currently, in addition to those collections, it is also home to 10 species of fish, 9 species of small mammals, and 6 species of birds. The Simeon Bornuțiu Central Park was established by the Women's Charity Association in 1827. It has existed for over 180 years and is one of the main places of recreation in Cluj-Napoca. It was here that the Summer Theatre was later inaugurated with a cinema division. It is now the headquarters of the Hungarian State Theatre, and during the interwar period, it functioned as the De Gerando Girls High School, now known as the Chemistry Faculty of the Babish Bolya University. There's also a group of statues around the fountain in the park. These were completely restored in 2009. The Casino Urban Culture Center was inaugurated in 2012 as an historic monument, given that the building was built at the end of the 19th century in a Viennese eclectic style. The monument held many roles over time. It was a casino, museum, school of fine arts, and a restaurant. Restored by the City Hall, the casino now hosts many cultural and artistic events specific to large European cities. Lake Chios is also located in Central Park, and it is truly an oasis of relaxation for the people of Cluj, and one of the tourist attractions that is usually on the list of those who visit Cluj. The lake was created in 1865 by the Association of Parks, who had taken over the care of the park. The association built alleys, dug a lake, and built the music pavilion. Today, in good weather, the lake is ideal for boat rides available to the people of Cluj and its tourists. The Lucian Blaga National Theatre and Romanian National Opera were founded in 1919, and they are the most important of their kind in Transylvania and among the most prestigious in Romania. Built between 1904 and 1906, the building is the work of renowned Austrian architects Helmer and Fellner. The hall is designed in a neo-Baroque style, with stylistic inflections inspired by secessionism in the decoration of the hallways, with director and actor Jeno Janovic being named director of the edifice. After the Second World War, the theater was extended and the first expansion sketches were applied in 1949. However, it wasn't until 1958 that the expansion was finished. As such, the new facades took on the style of the original building. In the 70s and 80s, two statues were placed in front of the theater. These were Eminescu and Blaga. On this occasion, the entry was altered and naturally made on a canopied platform. The carriageway was replaced by marble and then raised so that the interior reached a certain elevation. In addition, the stone steps were replaced with a marble staircase with steeper steps. This change was made only to fill the space between the two horizontal paths that were at different elevations. Initially, the length of the stairs unfolded in only half of this space. Both the facades as well as their interior structure are totally symmetrical. A series of stairs, and beside them, two side ramps, lead to the entrance of honor of the central axis of the main facade. The facades are eclectic, combining decorative elements taken from Renaissance and Baroque styles with secession elements of inspiration. Atop the central axis of the facade is a characteristic secession motif of a lyre, symbolizing the function of the building. The corners of the main jetty of the north facade are accentuated by two tall towers of 9 meters each, crowned with statues of allegorical compositions made of bronze. Apollo is on the eastern tower, and Thalia is on the western one, leading antique carts pulled by two lions and one lioness. The audience reception hall is dominated by a monumental staircase located in the central axis that allows movement to the public. The staircase splits on the landing of the mezzanine into two side branches that lead to the first floor. The auditorium, shaped like a horseshoe, is vertically fitted with two tiers of loges and a large balcony on the uppermost level. The Baroque decoration of the auditorium is arranged on the parapets of the loges and on the partition walls of the loges, and especially on the proscenium and on the ceiling. On the second tier, the left proscenium is decorated with the old emblem of Cluj, depicting three towers. The ceiling is decorated with a central rosette from which four meridians extend, richly decorated with floral motifs. Mirror Street is a unique location in Transylvania. The western side of the street was built in the 19th century in an eclectic style, following the trends of the times and inspired by architect Haussmann, who systematized Paris into a modern conception. This street was named after Iuliu Maniu, a great politician and former prime minister who held a prominent role in the unification of Transylvania with Romania. The name Mirror Street derives from two identical buildings at the entrance of the street coming in from Union Square. The architecture is dominated by neo-Renaissance buildings, with a characteristic of these buildings being the use of rigorous and precise historical forms adopted from Renaissance architecture. In the mid-1880s, architectural diversity appeared with elements of other historical styles being tried out, with the trend to mix different architectural elements within a single building. At the end of the century, during the late eclecticism period, instead of the authenticity of mature eclecticism becoming more important, the buildings with richly decorated facades, sometimes theatrical with an impressive dynamic, became more valued. The two buildings are almost entirely symmetrical, with the exception of the eastern and western facades. The south building is much wider, as it contains interior courtyards with elegant gazebos, with arches supported by pillars and slender columns. The corners of the buildings from the intersection of the Iuliu Maniu Street with the central square are each rounded and are accentuated with a tower covered with richly decorated helmets. The neo-Baroque facades of the buildings are decorated with grotesque masks. Eroilor Boulevard is one of the most important streets in Cluj-Napoca. During 2006, the southern side of the street was completely restored and opened to traffic at the end of that same year, while the north side was transformed into a pedestrian area in 2007. The street is one of the main commercial arteries in the city, and the largest Wi-Fi hotspot in Romania operates in the pedestrian area of Eroilor Boulevard, where any laptop, tablet, or smartphone user can connect to high-speed internet for free. The Cluj-Napoca railway station was inaugurated in 1870. History has it that in July 1867, a contest to construct the building and the Cluj-Oradea railway line was announced, and on January 7, 1869, the stone foundation of the building was set. It was completed in 1870 with the official opening of the new section. The building was built by the English firm Waring, following the plans of architect Carl von Gega, who died before the project was carried to an end. Funding for the work came from the Eastern Hungary Railway Company. On the sides of the railway station, you can observe Masonic signs, the square and the compass. The building was half destroyed in World War II and rebuilt in the 50s. The New York Continental Hotel is located in the southwest corner of Union Square and was built in the late 19th century. The eclectic work of art by Louis Paquet, the city's landscape architect of the early 20th century, the apartments of the New York Hotel hosted some of the most famous actors in Cluj and leading musicians, as well as well-known writers. As a result of the requirement to build a Western-style modern hotel-restaurant, in 1894, the decision to demolish the National Hotel and build a new hotel called Hotel New York in its stead was taken. Located at the intersection of two streets, the two facades of the building offer an ornate view in an eclectic architectural style. The main entrance was placed at the corner of the building and is accentuated by a tower. On the ground floor of this luxurious hotel, a cafe, named after the building, has functioned for several decades since the opening of the hotel. The Cluj-Napoca City Hall, the original headquarters of Cluj County, dates back to 1896 and is an architectural and historical monument built in the late 19th century and designed by architect Ignac Alpar. The building has two floors with two wings that run parallel. In the decoration of this eclectic palace, neo-Baroque elements dominate, with a number of artistic details of succession. The central axes and the extremities of the facades are highlighted by jetties. The attic of the central jetty is marked by a triangular pediment that frames the current emblem of the city. The first is a dynamic space thanks to its multiple ramps enclosed by neo-Baroque railings made of marble. The Cluj County Prefecture was built in 1910 by famous architect Joseph Huber as the headquarters for the Chamber of Commerce and Industry of Cluj. The building combines French Secession architecture with elements of Gothic and Renaissance styles, coupled with folk inspiration. The blueprint was designed in a composition of great plasticity, combining folk elements with those of the Gothic, Moorish Revival, and Secession styles. The interior spaces were modernized with predominantly classic styles and without extravagant touches. In the period between 1910 and 1940, the building functioned as the Chamber of Commerce and Industry. The Palace of Justice was built between 1898 and 1902 in an eclectic style. It is a building that represents early 20th century architecture. The building was designed by architect Julia Wagner and is cataloged as an historical and architectural monument. In the palace, several courts were, including the Cluj Court of Appeal. The building of the Palace of Justice is shaped like an irregular quadrilateral and contains 13 courtyards designed to provide ventilation and lighting for the rooms. There are two entrances, one in the northern facade and the second in the western one. Both facades are highly ornate, with each entrance consisting of a gateway made of four Doric columns that support a balcony on the first floor. The friezes were decorated with plant motifs, garlands, cantilevers, and rondebos figures. The arches, window frames, and eaves are decorated with human figures carved in stone, of exceptional artistic value. The decorative elements were made of terracotta and vishta stone, of which the quarry is just 20 kilometers away from Cluj. On the western roof of the facade, a dome 9 meters wide, 29 meters long, and 8.6 meters high was built. It is highly decorated with wrought iron pieces and with a covering consisting of a layer of Eternit slates that enhance the beauty of the building. The National Bank of Romania, Romania's central bank, is an independent public institution with a branch in Cluj-Napoca. The first note issued by the National Bank of Romania was 1,000 lei, and it circulated until 1933. The National Bank building that is still in use today was built in 1910 as the headquarters of a commercial bank that also sold insurance policies. The main facade has classical composition of eclectic style, with influences from Viennese art of the 1900s. The original plaster was cleaned and restored with smooth plaster on fiberglass mesh, and the decorative elements were cleaned and painted. The decorative elements made of stone were reconditioned or replaced locally. The facades of the interior courtyard were refurbished and repainted with a deep grit paint, and the brick plasterboard was cleaned. The roof covering was also replaced, with only the flat sheet metal being reused. The old Elizabeth's Bridge on the Somesh River was and has recently again become a point of origin for all those who are in love in the city that had previously gathered on the St. Valentine Bridge to attach huge heart padlocks to the metal railing or even to the bridge. It is said that over 100 years ago, on the Stronghold, there was a garrison town where the Catanese of Cluj lived their whole, or a good part of, their lives. At the beginning of the century, soldiers were serious matches for the marriageable girls in the city, and so arose an opportunity for girls coming from outside the city to be the maids for the newly married city women. The girls, genuine and strongly determined to marry quickly and to real men, soldiers in uniform, realized quickly that to make their dreams come true, they had to turn towards the hill to wait for their Prince Charming, as most houses were in the Mihai Viteazu Square or nearby, and the bridge was a stone's throw away. Every Sunday, before the few hours of leave that the soldiers had every week, the girls would perch near the bridge and wait for their knight in shining armor to appear. Emke Palace was built between 1890 and 1891 on the land of Count Gheorghe Banfi to honor the wishes of the Hungarian Railways, the tenant of the building. The Emke offices were located on the ground floor wing facing the square. On the frontispiece of this eclectic two-story building, with an area of 1,285 square meters, were lined the coats of arms of all the cities in which there was an Emke subsidiary branch. Now, on the facade that faces the square, you can see the figure 1885, which represents the year of establishment, and on the other wing, the figure 1891, representing the year that the building was finalized. Due to high maintenance costs, Emke sold the building to the Hungarian Railway, and after World War I, it became the property of the Romanian Railway. Seki Palace, located on Ferdinand Street, was built in 1893 by architect Pek Samu, the Hungarian neo-Gothic master. It belonged to Professor Tibor Seki, the rector of the Hungarian University between 1933 and 1934, and the greatest pharmacist of the time. The unmistakable silhouette of the building, raised on the shore of the Somesh River in an eclectic, neo-Gothic, austere, balanced, and elegant style, sheltered the Mattia Corvin Corner Pharmacy. The pharmacy's laboratory was directly tied to the owner's apartment by a metallic spiral staircase. The pharmacy still operates today on the ground floor, keeping the Gothic furniture and the decorations from the old apothecary. St. Peter's Roman Catholic Church, located on 21st December 1989 Boulevard, formerly St. Peter Street, was built in its current form in a neo-Gothic style in the mid-19th century on the foundations of an older church from the 15th century. It is located in the village of St. Peter, situated east of Cluj. The village was destroyed in one of the invasions of the Tartars and then rebuilt. In 1560, the church became Unitarian and it was again destroyed during the uprising of Rákóczi, and then rebuilt on its old location in 1711. 5 years later, it was returned to the Roman Catholics, and in 1724, it was used by the Minorites. The current edifice was raised between 1844 and 1846 by master craftsman Anton Kagerbauer on the site of the old church that had reached an advanced state of degradation. Initially, both the inside and the outside of the church were decorated to match the Coronation Church in Budapest. Its current appearance is due to changes made between 1844 and 1848. In 1977, the church was renovated. In front of the church is the imposing Baroque gateway, originally located in front of St. Michael's Church, and behind the church is a statue of the Virgin Mary that was originally located on University Street. The statue was moved to be saved from the communist government that did not approve of it. Both the church and the gateway were renovated. Until 1948, the St. Paraskeva Church was a Greek Catholic church dedicated to the Dormition of the Mother of God, belonged to the former Feleacu Monastery, completed in 1516, and built on the location of another monastery, probably made of wood. It is a monument of Gothic architecture designed as a church with a hall. It has two domed bays, of which the pointed arches are adorned in crosses, and an unhooked polygonal apse with a ribbed dome has mural paintings and religious iconographies from the 18th century. The church was restored in 1925 under the patronage of King Ferdinand of Romania, by architect Károly Kós when the tower was also built. From the Feleacu Monastery, a Slavic liturgy was copied in 1481, as well as four gospel books in 1488, at the orders of Archbishop Danil, who resided here. Thank you.